Hello Abaqus user, welcome to Abaqus Acumen for quick and sound learning. Today's session we are going to do on rotating body structured. So right now on my screen what you see is a rotating body, stresses generated within a rotating body. Before starting this particular tutorial, we strongly recommend you to go through our one tutorial is called on Abaqus CA, how to handle high speed rotational structure using Abaqus standard. So the tutorial which we are going to do today is on the how to handle a rotational body force. So tutorial is define how to define a rotational body force. So I'll just go to the drawing board. So we are going to understand more on the rotational body force, because in mechanical engineering you have several structures which are a rotating structure, and it is very important to find a rotational body force, how to apply it in Abaqus and how to analyze the structure. So if you see anything rotating about a center, so a person taking a ball and rotating about this causes centrifugal force, and the centrifugal force is called mr omega square, where omega is because of 2 pi n. So rotation about this structure and the mass, so combine of rotational velocity with mass causes centrifugal force, and then centrifugal force causes a stresses or pre-stress the model. So there are several structures in mechanical engineering, like you have wind build or centrifugal pump, or you have compressor, or you see something like a gear. So all this rotating structure will generate this centrifugal force, and that's what actually we'll do, how to do it. So we have taken a structure. Why we are not taken circular structure? We have taken a structure with some protruded sector, because I want to do one more after this, one more tutorial on sector symmetry. So I can use this example for the sector symmetry. That's the reason I taken this structure. So we are going to fix in the center, and then we'll apply this centrifugal force. So rotational body force will apply, and it's like a 75 radians per second. So we are going to use turn, newton, millimeter second. So this will be like a radians per second. So 750 rpm, that's what we'll apply. We are not putting any plasticity data, because any rotating body, if it goes in plasticity, that will generate mainly a permanent deformation. So structure are designed for only in elastic region. So we have put a elastic data, and then we'll come to something like a stress pattern, and then later on we'll start working on how we can do a sector symmetry problem out of this. So let me start the problem. So I'll say new, and then let me select the right working directory. So I'll create a part. It will be deformable solid extrusion 300, 500 will be overall. Then I'll put a 0, 0. I'll put 25, 0. I'll put 75, 0, and then I'll put 150, 0. So first I'll have a inner circle which is R24. Then I have R75, and then I'll put one more point here is like 0, 5. So I get a one point here, and then I'll put 150, -5. And then I'll just create like this. So I can create a rectangular block out of it. Now you can just rotate this by this, so you have this rotation. So if you see in your things, it will be like a linear pattern. So once you want to have to do a radial pattern, just go to add and then say radial pattern, and then you can rotate it. But before that, I'll just trim down this. I just don't want this all things. So I'll just rotate this. I'll select these two lines and that, and I'll say I want to have 8 360. So that way I created a rotating structure. So I can quickly go and delete something like this. I'll just delete the parts which I don't know, and then I'll put a fillet and extrude by 20 millimeter. That way we can. So I don't want this. We need to have very a close structure where you can. So we created the structure. Now we can quickly go and so somewhere it is not closed, so it's here. So let me see how. So let me first delete this. I'll just delete this and rotate the structure like this one. I'll say done, and just I want to have one, and I'll say 45. So I done here. So it was by mistake deleted, so I just created and then I'll delete. I'll just so I create this, then I quickly go and put a 5 millimeter radius. So we created that, and then we'll extrude this by 20, not 50. So you created the structure. Now we'll quickly give the metal property, which will be steel. Now since the mass is involved in this, so if you see here, there is a mass involved in this, so you need to give a density for this. So it's like a steel we are putting 7.85 e⁻¹⁹ turn per millimeter cube, and then we'll give elasticity data 210 e⁻¹⁰ and 0.3 as a Poisson's ratio, and then we need to really assign this as a solid section. So we've done that, and then we'll assign it. So we assign the section to it. So we done all part, then we'll quickly go and do assembly. So we created the assembly thing, and then we'll grow step, we'll say NL geom, we'll put NL geom on, nonlinear geometry on, we'll start with like 0.1 and then let it decide. Then we'll put a loads, boundary condition, we'll put end caster condition in the center. So we put that, and then we'll quickly go and put a. So you go to the load, you have concentrated force, line load, body force. You go rotational body force. You select whole part. This is my whole part. It's going to be rotational body force. It is asking axis of rotation. So it's asking the first point. I'm saying center, and then it is going to rotate about z axis. So I put 0,01. So this is give the axis of rotation, and then I'll put a 750 as my rotational velocity. So since it rotating about z axis, the body force will act in outward direction. We'll go and put a mesh. Main agenda for this was we'll go the same default one. We'll put this as a 5, and then we'll select this as a C3 DATR, and then we'll mesh it. So we quickly done a mesh. We could have done a better mesh than this. So let's select middle axis. That's better. Now put a mesh. It's okay. I think it's anyway. It's or hex dominated we'll say. Okay, it's coming same. So and then we'll say save the file. Rotational body force tutorial, and then I'll just give a job name, rotational body force, and we'll submit the run. See how then results come. And then so the whole idea was to give basic understanding of rotational body force. Also recommended strongly to go through this, you can understand a lot of basics for this. And we can use the same example to really use for creating mainly a sector symmetry. So the results complete. Let's check the results. We almost got closer to what we got, 35, because of mesh size. But this is what the main understanding learning was talking about, the rotational body force. That's what actually the whole intention of this. So thanks for watching it this video. Don't forget to like us and subscribe us.